Folks, welcome to our program. We're back in White Lake, South Dakota. White Lake Hunting Lodge. I tell you what, and I've got a great guest today. 38 years, me and this guy has been friends. He's from Atchison, Kansas now. It's taken us 20, I haven't seen him in 20 years. We used to hunt as young lieutenants together. Had an Army career, Ted retired, and decided to stay in Kansas. I couldn't get him back to the East Coast near South Carolina. So the best that I could do is to get you up here, okay, and hunt in South Dakota with us. You know, it's been so long since you and I have hunted over dogs, hunted pheasant, hunted. You know, I tell you what, we had a great year in Leavenworth. But Ted, I just want to thank you for coming up and being a guest on the show this week.
Well, I really appreciate the opportunity. It's a lot of fun to get back together with you and do this great hunting.
Well, you know, I tell you what, White Lake, South Dakota, who would ever thunk it? You know, I've been up here, yeah, I've been doing a lot of hunting over the years and, you know, as long as we've been doing this program, but, you know, I'm really excited about being back up here and just having you along as my sidekick and my wingman again.
Well, it's a great opportunity. It's such a beautiful place, and I really appreciate the opportunity to come back here and get on these pheasants. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Well, you know, just folks, getting him back in a pair of sunglasses, okay, and getting a shotgun in his hand, okay, is just going to be a feat in itself. But I'll tell you what, we've got a lot of great action on our show this week. Again, Ted Cook, Atchison, Kansas, out near Leavenworth, our old stomping grounds for a year. I'll tell you what, let's see if he's still got a bird or two left in him, all right? You ready?
I'm ready.
I'm ready. All right, man, come on. Let's... Woo! Oh, awesome, huh? There he goes, racing. Nice.
That's what I come down here for.
Ha ha! Woohoo!
Nice shot.
Great shot, James. Yeah, he did.
That was
yeah,
one
man.
Everybody will see that one.
Yeah.
That's the one everybody just, if you had a shot, you just shot that same pheasant.
Well, folks, listen, we're getting ready to start our hunt out here at White Lake. And, of course, Larry Smith, our host, has got us a great field of Milo to hunt over here this morning. You know, Ted, I tell you what, this is kind of different than what we used to hunt.
It is.
You know, Kansas, Missouri, and that sort of thing. And that's why I like coming up here. The family environment, great birds. I mean, these are all wild birds up here. And it's just awesome. And plus, it's easy walking.
Great opportunity and easy walking and easy shooting for us old men.
Yeah, man. There you go. Oh, speak for yourself, man. I'm telling you. Yeah, you're what, 3 years older than me?
Three.
Okay. That's what I like.
That's what I'm saying. Just
all right,
three.
Larry, man, we're ready to roll, and you are.
All right,
man. I know. 69. Woo! Folks, I tell you what, we got a great group with us this morning, okay? We got Mike Weeks from Atlanta, Georgia. We've got Larry's grandson, Medford Sorrels. On his right, you know Larry Smith. Then we got Jonathan South. And then over there, Ron Smith, one of our blockers. And then James DeBose from Charleston, South Carolina. We've got just a great, great rooster.
I was
get
right
him.
I was aimed up with James.
Woo! Here, that was your chance, brother. Your chance.
I was right aimed up with James.
He was right in front of me.
I had to pull up. Yep.
I was right in front of me.
Yeah, that's okay. That safety bird right there. Yeah. You know, folks, our technique today is, of course, we're walking and talking here as we push these birds out. And it's just one of the techniques that Larry uses. And as you've seen probably before, if you've ever come and hunted this way, of course, you've got blockers and standers at the other ends. You've got guys that walk along the side because, again, as you push these birds, they're going to run between all these rows. Again, I know the viewers out there that have pheasant hunted all their life, you understand, yeah, Redfern, you're just telling us. But for some of the folks that want to come up here and do this, I just felt the need to explain how Larry runs this thing, and he will benefit you in any way you want. If you want to come hunt, he'll make sure you get birds. All right, boys, we ready? There he goes, pheasant.
You got it.
It's down. Boom. Woo! Okay. I hate when those birds come around right over your head, okay? Yeah.
It's a good shot though. Excellent shot.
Oh yeah, all right.
You got it. You got it.
Oh
good
my goodness.
Good shot. Mm-hmm. Folks, like that big shot over
yeah,
there.
Yeah, I know. Well, the weather conditions this morning are wind. We probably got 15 knot wind, which is okay. That's typical for South Dakota. Temperature out here is probably in the low 50s, maybe high 40s. But I tell you what, when those birds get up and they get that wind behind them, boom, it is off to the races, off to the races. Let me tell you folks, at a quick point today, what I'm shooting with. I'm shooting the Browning 725 Citori. This is a grade 7 in 32-inch barrels, ported, backboard. This is a wonderful, wonderful shotgun out here. I really enjoy shooting this thing. No recoil, and I'm shooting Winchester Super Pheasant, 2 3/4, number 5 shot on a high brass magnum load. And I will tell you, this combination for pheasants in South Dakota, it is awesome. It is awesome. And with that, I tell you what, we go find a bird. They got to be more where that came from.
Today's Chevy destination takes us to White Lake Hunting Lodge, located 90 miles west of Sioux Falls, South Dakota. White Lake Hunting Lodge has been in operation for over 20 years, offering their customers great pheasant hunting, home-cooked meals, and expert guide service. If you love pheasant hunting or you have dreamed of going but didn't know where to go, then let White Lake Hunting Lodge give you an outdoor experience of a lifetime. For more information on White Lake, visit them online at whitelakehuntinglodgesd.com and book your trip today. Don't let this hunting season pass you by. If your next outdoor adventure takes you to South Dakota or anywhere else in this great country, make sure you're getting there in a new Chevy vehicle. For monthly specials or a dealer near you, visit Chevy.com.
I was really fortunate to be raised in a family with a strong outdoor heritage. We've been farming and hunting land that's been in our family since the Revolutionary War. Being good stewards of the land and wildlife and passing that on to future generations has always been part of our heritage. My grandfather created a company based on these values, and 70 years later, Pennington is still guided by these principles. This culture and these values are reflected in all of our products. Let us help you create your own outdoor legacy.
From bass and walleye to crappie and the great outdoors, you deserve more than old school aluminum. Reward yourself with the quality, performance, and extra room in a Ranger aluminum design. Packed with features, these rigs carry an ultra-smooth dry ride and stable platforms. Experience a Ranger aluminum boat today. It's engineered to excel and priced to be yours.
We were born to innovate, to find a better way. New Berkeley hard baits. New designs. Trigger loaded actions. Mind-blowing colors. Because everyone wants to catch more fish.
There's a certain pride in knowing our food comes from a place we love. Home. And when you consider all our state has to offer, you don't have to go too far to find great tasting food. So the next time you gather around a table, choose certified South Carolina grown, because here at home, it's a matter of taste.
Bob Redfern's Outdoor Magazine is brought to you by Chevrolet, the official vehicle of Bob Redfern's Outdoor Magazine. By Pennington Seed, the leader in outdoor forage products. By Browning, Browning, the best there is. And by Beanville Plantation, trophy bass and Florida's best quail hunting. By Northside, performance outdoor footwear for the whole family. And by Browning Ammunition, the dawn of a new generation.
folks, we're kind of relocating here, and that's one of the things that Larry does. He wants to keep all of his hunters and birds, and of course, it's a very special place. He has got habitat and all the arrangements for it, whether it's Milo, whether it's tall corn. I mean, Larry's got over 5,000 acres at his disposal to find wild pheasants. So with that, and that's why I decided to bring my good friend Ted Cook up here to hunt with me. You know, Ted, I tell you, have you ever seen habitat this nice?
No, I have not. It's perfect for hunting.
And we've hunted all over the country, you know, back in our younger day. Pheasant! Woo!
I was gonna shoot right over his head. I don't think so.
Nah, we call that a safety bird. There we go.
Dropped him at the end.
Blockers got him.
Lonnie probably knocked
him
down.
Yeah, he probably did. You know, I'll tell you, it's great because again, Buck has been out here. Gosh, he's 91.
91 years old.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm in that kind of shape.
How about that food?
Excellent.
Man, the ladies do put
it on. I'm out here walking all day, and I probably still gain 5 pounds.
You know, I will tell you, Monday night is steak night, folks. It's great Midwestern food, and it's more than you can eat, I can tell you. Rooster! Woo! Got him.
You want it?
No, man, I didn't shoot.
I shot. I got him right over there.
Okay.
I knew it was one of y'all.
No, it wasn't me. Rooster!
Nice shot.
Right. Got him.
Oh, now I got one. Woo-hoo.
Nice shot.
Hey. Yeah, man. Hey, Larry, I reached out and touched that one, brother. Huh? Hot dog. Woo-hoo.
Boomer says, I gotta go get it.
Get that bird. Find that bird, Gracie. Come on, get out here, girl. Come here. Oh, Gracie. Oh.
Sit.
Good girl. Good girl. You gonna let me have that bird? Huh?
Release.
Let me go have that bird. Oh, wow. Thank you, Gracie. Folks, I will tell you, White Lake Hunting Lodge up here in South Dakota is just an awesome place. I can't highly recommend any place else to come in South Dakota. This is a great family place, great food. It's just an awesome, awesome location, and that's our destination this week. You're gonna be able to come up here, hunt pheasant, wild pheasant, just like this, through beautiful fields. Larry Smith and all the gang up here will welcome you up. Log on to bobredfern.com, go to Bob's Top 16, and you too can come on up here and hunt pheasants with the best of us. And with that, gotta be more. Gracie, what are you thinking? Huh?
Yeah.
What are you thinking? All right. You know, Ted, I tell you, that's what's so great about what Larry's done here is, of course, again, walking online. Everybody gets an opportunity to shoot. And even if guys can't walk, they're a little mobility impaired or whatever, you can be a stander or a blocker, as they want to call it, and you'll get to be able to pass shoot these birds.
That is what's great about hunting up here in this style behind these flushing dogs is you can either walk or stand.
Exactly.
Your mobility is not a hindrance.
Yeah. There he goes, rooster. Well, that one escaped us. Here.
I was down on the ground low. You can shoot out any way you want to shoot.
I'm telling you.
It's hard to hit them when they're flying away from you.
I know it is.
You know.
They're moving quick. They get on that wind and ride.
I thought I had a pretty good beat.
You did good. I'm glad you're shooting.
He evaded you.
Well, I'm a looter.
Yeah, you evaded you. That's all right, man. We'll get you one next time. Mm-mm.
Good job.
Good job, Boomer.
Folks, coming up next is another great recipe on this week's Sportsman's Table.
South Carolina law prohibits anyone from operating a moving motorized vessel or vessel under sail while under the influence of alcohol, drugs, or a combination thereof. If you must drink, please have a designated driver. Remember, be safe, boat sober.
How's it going?
Hi.
Today we're going to be comparing the roll-formed, high-strength steel bed of the Chevy Silverado to the aluminum bed of this competitor's truck.
Awesome.
All right, let him drop.
Let's see how the aluminum bed of this truck held up.
Wow.
That's a good-sized puncture.
That's all the way through, for sure.
Full-on crack here.
You're aluminum now, you're going to go, ooh.
Let's check out the Silverado steel bed.
Wow.
Yeah, a couple dents.
I'd expect more dents.
Chevy clearly held up better than the Ford.
If you're in the market for military surplus for recreation or construction, or you just want to own a piece of military history, go online to GovPlanet.com's weekly auction. GovPlanet has auctions every Wednesday, where you can find and bid on numerous items. All items are protected by ironclad assurance, which makes sure that what's in GovPlanet's report is what you're getting. Be sure to join GovPlanet every Wednesday for their weekly auction, and check in often to see their ever-changing inventory. GovPlanet, your online auction site for government equipment.
Engineered to excel, the Ranger Z500 and Z100 series are built for the ultimate ownership experience. It's a commitment to excellence packed with real-world advantages and exclusive features. Experience the accelerated performance standards of the Ranger Z series. From first light to last cast, these advanced designs are put together to set you apart.
On South Carolina waterways, each child under the age of 12 must have on a personal flotation device in any boat under 16 feet. Make sure that all boats have flotation devices when you're on the waterways for your safety and the safety of others.
The Sportsman's Table. Brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. Remember, buy South Carolina. It's a matter of taste.
Folks, welcome to this week's Sportsman's Table Recipe. We have a special guest this week, our chef, Nancy Carlson, here at White Lake Hunting Lodge. We're out here pheasant hunting this week on our show, and we thought we'd take a special time to talk about a great pheasant recipe that we had right here during our stay at the lodge. Nancy, thank you very much for being our guest today. Okay, our guest chef, certified SC grown. Listen, pheasant, there. Yeah. All right, tell us how you're going to do the pheasant and what you did.
Well, first of all, I made my sauce earlier today. So it consists of pheasant stock that I debone and use the bones to make a stock. And it's basically a white sauce with mushrooms. I put some fresh garlic in it, salt and pepper, some smoky paprika. I made a seasoned flour just with also smoky paprika, garlic, salt, pepper. And what I'm going to do is take my pheasant breasts that have been marinating in buttermilk for about 4 hours.
Okay.
Tenderizes them, plus keeps the moisture in, adds moisture to them.
Well, I'll tell you what, you want me to hold the flour while you dip them. How about that?
Absolutely.
Can I help?
Unless you want to get your fingers
dirty. No, that's okay. You can do that.
Okay. Huh? So we just take it, and we're going to let them sit just for about a minute or so on the plate. So
There we go. Okay.
While the flour just sets in a bit, so it
okay. Does that kind of dry up?
It will, and it'll keep them from getting soggy.
I got you.
The breasts from getting soggy and holding in too much oil.
And deboning these pheasant breasts. Now, how long does that take you?
I'm actually getting quite good at it. We have a great Wyatt is our cleaner who does all the pheasants.
I got you.
And he just does a wonderful job. And he brings them to me with on a double lobe, and we just cut them off. And
Awesome.
It's very easy. And then you really have the bones, which are nice for a stock.
Okay.
So
all right. I'm now we let them sit. There we go.
Just put that in. And
now how long are these going to cook?
They're just until you brown them on both sides.
Really? So it's really
it's
a minute
really
or
fast
so.
Because what you're going to do then is you're going to put them in the oven and slow cook them to finish them off for an hour and a half or so. So we're just going to let these brown up really nice. Okay, we're going to give these check, and they're nice little brown. So we'll turn them over
awesome.
And get them brown on the other side. Okay, Bob, they're ready to go. They've drained some. I'm going to put a little sauce on the bottom just so they don't stick.
Wow, that sauce smells great.
Yeah, it's a nice, good little sauce.
Wow.
That's a bit, and then we'll take our breasts and just line them up.
And that's all there is to it.
It's pretty easy.
Wow.
And the nice thing about this is you can leave it in the oven on low heat, and preferably on a low heat, and it will... you have the rest of the afternoon to go hunting.
There you go. Wow.
So we'll just cover this.
Well, Miss Nancy, I tell you what, I am looking forward to sampling the finished product on this. Now we're going to pop this in the oven. You're going to cover it. Okay.
We're going to cover it. We're going to put it on 275 and probably for an hour and a half.
And that's it.
And that's it.
There you go. Okay.
Okay, I think they're just about ready to go.
275 for an hour. Yep. All right.
And there you go.
Oh, my goodness. Wow, and they smell great, Miss Nancy.
We usually give, you can have two breasts as per serving.
Now, what do you normally serve here at the lodge for vegetables? Of course, it's a buffet, right?
Correct. We would do, I would like to do like a mixed vegetable, California bread, broccoli, cauliflower, and carrots. And we will have rice with the pheasant.
Oh, goodness.
So you could use the sauce on the rice.
Well, there, I tell you what, it is just awesome. Thank you so much for being
welcome.
A guest on this week's Sportsman's Table. And folks, if you would like to have Miss Nancy's recipe, just log on to bobredfern.com, go to the Sportsman's Table, and her recipe for this wonderful wild pheasant will be right there. And remember, buy South Carolina. Certified South Carolina grown. Log onto their website and see what's fresh on your menu today.
If you would like more information on South Carolina grown products, visit them online at certifiedscgrown.com. Remember, buy South Carolina. It's a matter of taste.
Welcome.
Hi.
Today we're going to be comparing the roll-formed, high-strength steel bed of the Chevy Silverado to the aluminum bed of this competitor's truck.
Nice.
You want to grab that empty toolbox for me? Let's start here with the aluminum bed.
That's wow. A big hole.
Huge.
We got Swiss cheese for a truck here.
I'm curious to see if that will do the same thing with the Chevy.
Well, let's find out. Same spot, same angle, same empty toolbox.
Took it way better.
The steel held up.
Silverado proved it is the toughest truck here.
Bienville Plantation is America's number one sportsman's paradise. At Bienville Plantation, sportsmen may choose to follow champion bird dogs while upland bird hunting on some of the best habitat that North Florida can offer. Or you may have the opportunity to land that trophy bass of a lifetime on the numerous lakes that Bienville Plantation has on its property. Bienville also offers luxury accommodations and fine dining for individuals or corporate parties. Bienville Plantation, where we make outdoor dreams come true.
Stronger, tougher, still just as ugly. Introducing the next generation Ugly Stick GX2. Ugly never quits.
Bob Redfern's Outdoor Magazine is brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources, Life's Better Outdoors, and by Ugly Stick GX2, America's strongest, most sensitive rod, by the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. Nothing's fresher, nothing's finer. By Ranger Boats, still building legends one at a time. And by GovPlanet, the best place to buy surplus equipment.
All right, Ted, I just can't stand to see you carry that smoke pole any farther, okay? If I had a ditch, I'd put that thing in it, okay? I'm even embarrassed. I thought I raised you better than that in the hunting field. So, folks, I got to put this Browning 725 Citori in Ted's hands because I'm really afraid that he's not going to get a pheasant up here, okay? Because the thing he's shooting, it's even an unmentionable. I'm going to have to lay it over here in the grass. If we don't find it, when we come back down through here, there you go.
All right.
Plenty of shells for you. All right. Here, wait a minute. I'm even going to give you some extras. All right.
Now, sir, thank you.
Yeah, with that, okay. Lee, let me. I'm just
not guaranteeing you're going to get it back.
Well, that's okay. All right, pheasants, here we come.
And my window's right there.
I know. I'm telling you.
See, if he starts moving, he narrows my window real quick. Not putting it over his head.
Well, I'll tell you, it just brings back memories of when we used to have my dogs in the field.
Yeah, we spent a lot of time behind those dogs.
Yeah, we did. I'm down to one now. Buddy, right Pete, there. Riley, Ben, Casey, Ace, Maverick. Gosh, I've had a lot of them.
We spent a lot of time behind Buddy.
Yeah.
In a number of different states.
Man, I used to say my bird dogs had more air time than I did. There he goes. Take him, Tim. Come on, get him, Bo. Now, right there, folks. Ted Cook behind the Browning shotgun, man. He did become one with a gun. Oh, my goodness.
Huh?
Woo! Did you see that, huh? Man, oh, man. Look at that. Gracie, come
I would have told you.
Come here, girl. Oh, she's going to Dad. Listen, now, how did that feel?
When we were younger, I would have told you I would have never carried it through a 32-inch barrel. And that swung so easy.
Yeah.
And the palm swell right here, it just fits. It's a nice gun.
Folks, this is unscripted too, because you have never shot a bird.
No.
Huh? And that's what I always say this is a shotgun you can take out of the box in the morning and pop caps in the afternoon. I mean, it is absolutely the smoothest swinging and the best out of the box shotgun I have ever, ever in my life owned.
Oh, it's a beautiful piece of machinery. Oh,
so you are going to give it back to me, huh?
Yeah.
So we got to put this one away. Oh, my gosh. Just keep that thing down.
Well, if you let me have it, I'll take it right out of here.
But one with a gun, but remember that. Browning, the best there is. All right, man. All right, Larry. Can you believe it? Mm-mm. It better not be another.
It won't.
It better not be, okay? I know I live on the East Coast and you live in the Midwest, but, you know, I just have to ask you, now what do you think about White Lake, South Dakota?
It is a great location with a great time, and they get you in the birds. And I probably gained 10 pounds. I don't know. I'm going to do this 2 or 3 times a year. I'm going to be an overweight old man.
Well, you know, it's all about destinations on our program, Ted. And you know, we've been doing this over 15 years. Matter of fact, our 500th episode is going to come out here, and so we'll show the best of it. But it's because of friends like you that I enjoyed hunting and fishing all through my military career. But I will tell you, folks, I have to say one thing. The last time we were really together, that we hunted over shotguns was, what, 25 years ago?
25 years ago.
My daughter was born in Kansas City, Kansas, and Ted was there. As a matter of fact, he was the first guy that got the call, and he stayed there in the waiting room, and my daughter, Camille, was born there, and you were right there with me.
I was there.
Yeah, and then
watching
we went
Bobby.
And then we went hunting the next day.
That's right. Yeah, we kind of got a little chastised for that, but yeah, we did.
Yeah,
we did. We had a lot of fun.
Well, I just tell you, thank you so much for joining
thank
us up here, Ted. And again, you're the best. And folks, I will tell you, on our show, again, it's all about family, friends. We used to say fishing, but it's also about hunting with those folks that you enjoy spending time with the most. And just like today, again, with Ted Cook coming all the way up to White Lake, South Dakota. The outdoors has been his passion. I've now showed you, okay, he has become one with the gun. But I would just like to say to all my family and friends out there, couldn't have done it without all of you all, and you're a big part of that as well. I consider you just the brother I never had.
Thank you very much. It was a great time. And a wonderful location.
Yeah, man. And with that, folks, listen, as I always say, the outdoors is my passion. I want it to be yours, too. We'll see you next week.